Lord say so. Come on, let's go ahead and enter into worship. Come on, if you will, if you can get off your feet and give God some praise in this house. Can we go ahead and stand for praise and worship? Hallelujah. It's good to be in the house of the Lord one more time, isn't it? Say hallelujah. Hallelujah.
All around. is all around.
Hallelujah. Come on and clap your hands in this place. Come on, clap your hands if you love Jesus. We serve an awesome God. Hallelujah. Don't we serve an awesome God in this place? Hallelujah. His name reigns above all names. Hallelujah. Come on, we come to magnify his name together. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, yes, God. Hallelujah. Come on, lift your hands all over the place. Come on, show signs of serenity. Surrender. Hallelujah. Come on, surrender your all to him. Come on, thank him for his goodness. Come on, thank him for his mercy. Come on, you ought to have signs. It says, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Hallelujah. You ought to show signs of his goodness. That means open up your mouth and give him praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's awesome. He's an awesome friend. He's an awesome counselor. He's an awesome provider. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
He's an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God.
Hallelujah, if you'll believe it, lift your hands all over the place. Hallelujah.
Some power and love, our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with
wisdom,
power, and
above
with some power and love.
awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with some power and love. Our God is an awesome God. Come on, everybody, say, our God.
Our God is an awesome God. He
reigns above all names. Come on, that's nobody bigger than our God. That's nobody better than our God. Come on, love on him this morning. Come on, if you're expecting something this week, come on, reach up and grab it. Reach up and grab your blessing. Hallelujah, because his name reigns above all names. Hallelujah, you serve an awesome God. Hallelujah, we serve a big God. We serve a great God. He's an omnipotent God. He is the rose of Sharon. Hallelujah.
Our God is an awesome.
Come on.
God, he reigns from heaven above.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You're worthy of our praise. You serve a mighty God. Hallelujah.
God be praised. It's good to be in the house one more time. I know some of you are just like I am, because God has been so good to you, brought you through so much, carried you all the way, delivered you, redeemed you, that you just feel obligated to be in the house of the Lord on Sunday morning just to praise his holy name. Wave your hand and say, Lord, we thank you. Lord, we praise you. Lord, you're wonderful. Lord, I owe you all that I can give to you on today. Are any of you like that in the house? Praise his name. He is an awesome God, and he's worthy of all our praise. And so thank you for entering into his courts, into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Amen. God be praised. God be praised. Now it's time for our prayer, our altar prayer, and I want to encourage you to find your praying ground. What do you mean when you say praying ground? That spot, that position where you know that you can get a prayer through. If it is standing, if it is kneeling, if it was prostrating yourself, if you got to change position, if you want to come down to the altar. Wherever you feel that you can get a prayer through, right now I want you to find your praying ground. I want you to make you have a sick and death report. On your sick report, I want you to add Reverend Benita Barnes, who's in the hospital at this time. Reverend Benita Barnes in the hospital. And then add on our death report Ethel Lee Field, who is the sister of Artilia King and the aunt of Pat King. And that funeral will take place on Tuesday, April the 11th in Birmingham, Alabama. Add these to your list and pray for them along the way. They are in need of your prayer. Amen? Amen, amen. Now, as you find your praying ground, we're so excited this morning because we know that God hears and answers prayer. So as you get to your praying ground, I'm going to ask our own Deacon Perry Jordan to come and lead us to to the throne of God's grace. Deacon Perry Jordan. Take everything to God in prayer. Father, we come to you this morning, Lord, as we always do, Father, just recognizing, Father, that you are the master and controller of this universe, Father. Lord, we thank you, Father, and we give you all praise and all the honor and all the glory, Father. We say right now, Father, hallelujah to your name, Father. Lord, we just say thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Lord, thank you for keeping the stars up in the sky. Lord, thank you for guiding our path as we walk down life's highway. Father, thank you, Lord, for keeping our relationships in place. Father, just thank you, Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Lord, as I stand here now, Father, I must say thank you, Lord, for the privilege of prayer. Lord, sometimes we don't take advantage of it like we should, Father. But you said, Lord, in your word that you have not because we ask not, Father. So, Father, forgive us, Lord. But forgive us for not talking to you, Lord, as we need to, Father. Forgive us for not talking to you about the big things that are concerning us, Lord. Forgive you, Lord, for not talking to you about the small things that concern us, Father. But Lord, forgive us, Lord, for not talking to you for the blessings that you bestowed upon us, Father. Lord, yes, sometimes we see your blessings, Father. Sometimes we see you blessing other folks. But Father, I'm quite sure that oftentimes we don't see all the things you're doing in the background, Father. So right now, as we stand here this morning, we just want to say thank you. Thank you, thank you. Lord, there are people that have gathered around the altar this morning, Father. And everyone under the sound of my voice right now, Father, has cares and concerns that they're worried about, Lord. But Lord, sometimes we forget, Lord. We forget to look back, Father, over the mountains that you brought us over, Lord. Lord, everyone who's listening under the sound of my voice has been sick. And Father, you brought us through it. Father, everyone under the sound of my voice right now, Father, has lost loved ones, and you comforted us through it, Father. So give us the strength, Lord, to just sometimes look back, Father, and look back over the mountains that you brought us through, Father, and it would help us to keep moving forward, Father. so that we will be that light, Father, that you would have us to be, Father, so that other people can look at us and say, there goes Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, thank you. Lord, we ask of you, Lord, that you would forgive us of our sins, forgive us of our transgressions. Lord, we ask that you would bless this place called Brentwood right now, Father. Father, bless all the ministries, Father. Bless the leader, Father, in the name of Joe Samuel Radcliffe, Father. Crown his head with wisdom and knowledge, Father. And as my deacon brother oftentimes says, Father, prop him up on every leaning side, Father. So, Father, continue to bless him and lead him as you would have him to go, Lord. Bless the staff that continues to support him on a daily basis. And then, Father, I ask that you would let your spiritual fertilizer be cast out this morning, Father, for the word that you would have to have spoken this morning, Lord. Let it reside in our hearts, Father, so that it might come forth at some time in the future and so that you might receive the glory. Now, Lord, for all the things that I've neglected to pray about, Lord, for all the things that I don't know to pray about, for all the things that are still rolling around in my mind, Father, that time won't let me get to, Father, ask that you be granted in your grace, your goodness, and your mercy, and we'll be ever so mindful to give you the glory, honor, and praise. Father, thank you, and continue to just work in our lives, continue to bless us. It is in your Son, Jesus' name, we do pray. Amen.
Something about that. Now just wave your hand if you know there's something about that name, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise his name, praise his name. Now, if you are a first-time visitor, this is your first time at Brentwood, this is your first time here, we're asking that you would stand that we might recognize you on this morning. This is the first time here. Please stand. Here's one. Where's some more? Remain standing until someone has, there are two in the back, until someone has placed a card in your hand. When you have received that card, you may then be seated. Now, if the person that invited you, if you could see them, point to them, say, now, you stand. Who invited you?
You stand. Okay.
Amen. God be praised. Amen. Thank you for getting them here this morning. Thanking you for inviting them. That means all the difference in the world. Amen. Now, the card that was given you, we're asking you to fill that card out on both sides. Someone around you will make sure that you have something to write with. We want you to fill both sides of that, the bottom portion of that card, fill both sides out. And then, when the offering plate passes, place that card, the bottom portion, in the offering plate, and we'll be in touch with you in days to come. We are so excited that you're here this morning. I want to thank you for passing up other churches and making your way, pressing your way to Brentwood, and we declare that you will not be disappointed. You're going to have a good time as you join with us in worshiping our God and hearing a word from the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So thank you, so thank you, thank you. Now, and also let me say that this is not your first time worshiping with us. We want to invite you to become a part of us. That means joining with us as a member. We'd love to have you as a part of our family. We'll love on you, we'll support you, we'll help you in any way we can up the King's Highway. And the way you begin that process is when the invitation is extended. And how do you know that? Brothers and sisters are gonna line up in the aisles and they're gonna extend their hands. Then you know that's your cue to get up, start walking down, and we'll take it from there. We'll take real good care of you. We'll take real good care of you. Our pastor would love to be your pastor, and we love to be your brothers and sisters in the Lord and from this family. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So go and encourage you on that way. Now, my favorite time. My favorite time. Would everyone please stand? If you're not filling out your envelope, if you're not filling out your check, if you're not writing a visitor's card, stand. I want you to look around. Look all around. Look all around and see how good people are looking, how good you looking, how good people are smelling. Everybody looking good, smelling good. But let me just share something with you. All of us are going through something. All of us got issues, we got problems, and I'm telling you, we got problems here and problems there. Now, what I want you to do, everybody say this for me. Say this for me. Say this for me. Be healed in Jesus' name. Let me hear you say it again. Be healed in Jesus' name. Now, don't do like that 745 crowd did. When I say let's fellowship, let's walk and fellowship, most of them sat right back down. Don't do that. I want you to walk around, encourage somebody, fellowship, and whatever you say to them, say, in Jesus' name, be healed. Now, we're going to fellowship about 2 minutes. 2 minutes, let's fellowship, tell somebody, be healed in Jesus' name, let's fellowship.
me to walk.
A good time this morning? Hallelujah. I'm having a good time. I hope you're having a good time. Hallelujah. We thank God for our male chorus. They're sounding unusually good today. Amen. Thank y'all. Thank y'all. Thank y'all. Amen. 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 God be praised. Y'all look like y'all had a good time fellowshipping. Amen. Amen. Good, 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 good. We're almost up to our offering time. Our offering time is when the plates are gonna pass twice. And the first time they pass is going to be for our benevolent offering. Now, let me share that what that's for. Brentwood is known for helping individuals when they are in the crossroads of life. And they come to us, they are sent to us. Some of you send them to us. Some of you been to us. And so that's what the first offering is for, our benevolent offering. And we need for you to give, and we're asking you to give, $5 each Sunday. So when they come to us, we'll be able to give. Amen? To help them out. Amen. We want you to do that. Now give $5 in the first offering. Preferably put it, if you need an envelope to put it in, hold your hand up. And we will get you an envelope to put it in. That's the first offering, $5. Then the second offering is for our tithes and offerings. If you've made a commitment to pay your tithes, if you've made a vow, what you mean make a vow? Well, you found yourself in a scrape one time between a rock and a hard place, and you know how you're going to make it. You told God, God, if you get me through this, I will pay my tithes. I will give an offering from here on. Well, you know, don't forget that. Yeah, no, don't forget that. Keep your commitment. Keep your vow to the Lord. Amen? Because you know it may come up again. It may come up again. You may find yourself in a scrape again. Amen? And so we want to honor the Lord this morning with our tithes and our offering. On that yellow sheet of paper, we're going to read the offertory reading. It's offering time. Hey, yay, 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 yay. Lord, I thank you today for the ability and willingness to offer you my time, my talent, and my tenth. I dare not come into your house empty-handed. I am standing on the promises of God. Amen. We have emphasis from Reverend Dr. Ford this morning. Come, Reverend Dr. Ford.
Good morning, Brentwood. We are quickly approaching the festivities of our Easter week, and starting on this coming Wednesday at 7 p.m., we will begin our festivities with our pre-Easter praise and worship concert. In concert will be First Bishop Yvette Flunder. And y'all know this song, right? This is her song. Come on, somebody help me sing it. Y'all know it. All you've done for me. Y'all know that. Y'all know that. And so we know we're going to have a good time. But not only are we going to have Bishop Yvette Flunder here on this coming Wednesday, but we have another special guest, Bishop Carlton Pearson. And you probably wrecked your car a couple of times. Almost wrecked your car a couple of times listening to Bishop Carlton Pearson. Because he will take you back to the old school. And y'all all heard the Lord will make a way somehow, huh? Y'all know it. Come on, sing it with him.
He'll make a way.
Come on, y'all know it.
For you and for me.
Y'all know it. Come on, help us.
We'll see you.
He'll see you safely through.
I know the Lord.
He'll make a way. He'll make a way. Yes, he will.
Oh, yes, he will.
So y'all know who's coming. Y'all heard them. I'm sure you have their music. Listen, we want you to come out on this coming Wednesday, but just don't come by yourself. Make sure you bring about five or six people with you, because on this coming Wednesday, we're going to have a foot-stomping, hand-clapping good time in the Lord. Amen? Amen. Listen, we look forward to seeing all of you on this Wednesday, but that's not all. On Friday, April 14th at noon, we will have our Good Friday worship service in the sanctuary, and Dr. Ratliff will be preaching. Then on Saturday, April 15th, is the Easter egg hunt at 10 a.m. in the LLC. On Sunday, we will have our Easter worship at 6, 8, and 10 a.m. Amen? Sunday school will take place at 8 a.m. And then we will have our children's church as well as jam at 10 a.m. The children's church will put on their annual Easter play in the sanctuary, and jam will take place in the LLC. Listen, we look forward to seeing you at our Easter festivities, and we hope that you just don't come alone, but bring someone and let them know that we serve a risen Savior who's in the world today. Amen? Amen.
Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. We want to thank God for our pastor and his vision of bringing these artists in. Last year, who did we have last year? Who came last year? Shirley Caesar came last year. Amen. So he brings the artists in. Now, we do want to make you aware that all seats are free on Wednesday night. All seats are free. But we will take up an offering. So come prepared to give something, amen,
for that expense. Amen. God be praised. God be praised. We want to make also you aware about our scholarship fashion show will be held Sunday, May the 21st at the Hilton Americas, Houston. The theme is Out of Africa. Tickets are available today in the foyer. Thank you, Brentwood, for making it possible for so many youth to pursue an education of higher learning through your support of this function. Amen? And then youths in grades 6 through 12 are invited to travel with us to June 19th through the 28th to the National Baptist Convention Congress in Orlando, Florida. The cost is $700. That covers transportation. That covers hotels. They're going to be at the Universal Studios. They're going to tour the Bethune-Cookman University. They're going to tour Edward Waters College. They're going to tour Florida A&M University. They're going to tour Southern University and much more. All that for $700. Amen. 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 Contact Reverend Frazier or visit the table in the foyer for details and how you can hook up your child in grades 6 through 12 for that event. Amen? Amen. I'm finished, and I want to get out of the way. We're going to hear from this marvelous men's course, and then we're going to hear from our preacher from the for today, Reverend Tracy Collins.
Spent in vanity and pride, caring not my Lord was crucified, knowing not it was for me.
Me. Somebody ought to shout hallelujah. Anybody got a hallelujah left? Anybody got a hallelujah in their spirit? Anybody got a hallelujah in their hands? Anybody got a hallelujah in their voice? Anybody got a breath? You got breath in your body. You ought to be able to say hallelujah. Hallelujah. He is wonderful. Anybody love him this morning? I mean, really in love with him and not ashamed to let the world know I'm in love with Jesus, because he's done so much for me. Kept me when I couldn't keep myself. Held me when I couldn't hold myself. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. If you knew his story, you'd understand his praise. I remember when he used to ride the bus to St. John from Antoine in 290 in the rain and would be soaking wet when he got there. But when it was all over, after shouting and thanking God, he'd be dry. That's your heart. I'm thankful to God today to be in this place and thank Pastor for allowing me to stand and declare the word of God in the place that he stands. Declare the truth about Jesus to you. Two of my sisters are here, and one of my adopted sisters is here, Karen and Peggy. And my oldest sister is with me today, Sharon Walter, Mrs. Sharon Walter. when she walked in, I thought it was my mother. My mother's been gone a little while. Thank you for coming today. Y'all have to excuse me. I cry a little bit every now and then. Y'all mind if I get it out? He's a wonder in my soul. He's a wonder in my soul. Yeah, a wonder in my soul. And every chance I get, I'm gonna bless. Bless. I'm gonna bless his name. In Mark chapter 11, verse 1, I'll read to you some verses from the New Living Translation. As Jesus and his disciples approached Jerusalem, they came to the towns of Bethpage and Bethany. On the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two of them on ahead. Go into the village over there, he told them. And as soon as you enter it, you will see a coat tied there that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone asks what you are doing, just say, the Lord needs it and will return it soon. The two disciples left and found the coat standing in the street, tied outside a house. As they were untying it, some bystanders demanded, what are you doing untying that coat? They said what Jesus had told them to say, and they were permitted to take it. Then they brought the coat to Jesus and threw their garments over it, and he sat on it. Many in the crowd spread their coats on the ground ahead of Jesus, and others cut leafy branches in the fields and spread them along the way. He was in the center of the procession, and the crowds all around him were shouting, praise God, bless the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Bless the coming kingdom of our ancestor David. Praise God in highest heavens. So Jesus came to Jerusalem and went into the temple. He looked around carefully at everything, and then he left because it was late in the afternoon. Then he went out. Disciples. The grass withers, flowers fade away, but the word of God will stand forever. Gracious God, our Father, speak now that we might speak to your people in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Speak through us, to us, and for us. And we will be careful to give you the praise. In your Son's name, amen. It was the first day of the week. Jesus is on the Mount of Olives, overlooking Jerusalem. However, before the sun sets the following Friday, Jesus will have been crucified and buried. Before the sun rises on the next Sunday morning, Jesus will have conquered death, hell, and the grave by resurrecting from the dead. The events on this day mark the beginning of our Lord's Passion Week, or as we would call today, Palm Sunday. Up to this point in the ministry of Jesus, he had always told men to keep quiet about his identity. Often, when he healed people, he would tell them to go their way and keep quiet about it, and not let anybody know what he had done for them. The old people used to sing a song, "I said I wasn't gonna tell nobody, but I just couldn't keep it to myself." Now there is a shift in the Lord's strategy. On this day, Jesus begins to draw attention to himself. Why? I'm glad you ask. He does so because he's about to fulfill an ancient prophecy. He does so because he is about to present himself to the nation of Israel as their king. Hundreds of years earlier, the prophet Zechariah penned these words: "Rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion. Shout, O daughter of Jerusalem. Behold, thy king cometh unto thee. He is just and having salvation, lowly and riding upon an ass, and upon a coat of the foal of an ass." Zechariah 9:9. Jesus is about to fulfill that prophecy in detail. I believe that there are some precious jewels that can be gleaned from this moment in our Savior's life. Have I got a witness in here? I want to borrow my title from the verse in Zechariah. He said, "Behold, thy king cometh unto thee." In verses 1-6, we see the person of this king. It's early in the morning, and Jesus makes preparations to go to Jerusalem. He is moving through two little villages near the top of the mountain. He is in Bethpage, which means house of unripe figs, and Bethany, which means house of dates. Jesus had raised Lazarus from the dead in John chapter 11, and now he stands on the top of Mount of Olives, preparing to descend into the city below. Jesus could see the beautiful city spread out before him. From the top of this mountain, which stands some 2,600 feet above sea level. This all happened during the week leading up to Passover. The population of Jerusalem at this time was somewhere around 80,000 people. However, during the Passover, some 2 to 3 million people would crowd into the city for the celebration. The people came in anticipation. They were looking for God to do something. And I just need to stop right here and ask you, when you come to church, do you come looking for God to do something? Do you come looking for God to change the way you feel about something? To change the way you're thinking about something? Do you look when you come to church to get re-energized, to be recharged, to go back out into the world and fight the demons, and the battle of life? The truth of the matter is, God would do his greatest work of all times during this Passover. But most people, get this, most of the people would miss it altogether. Jesus chose this moment to reveal himself to the nation of Israel. He chose this moment to let Israel know that their king had arrived. Have I got a witness in here? Jesus sends two of his disciples to a village to get a donkey, to get a colt, to get an ass. He tells them exactly where they'll find it and what the people around them will say to them. He even gives them some details about the animal. When his men got out to complete this assignment, they find everything just as Jesus said it would be. Isn't the Lord like that? Whenever he tells you how something is going to turn out, have I got a witness in here? It's always just like that. I can reflect on the word of God, which says, my God will supply all of your needs according to his riches and glory. And every day he supplies. Any witnesses in the house? Now, some writers suggest that Jesus set this up aforetime. They said that Jesus went to the owner of this little coat and made preparations and arrangements for the coat to be used at this particular time. I happen to believe differently. I believe he set it up in his sovereignty. I believe that God knows all, sees all, and is handling all. And so this shows us that Jesus is God and that he's in control. Somebody say control of everything. When you wake up in the morning and you say, good morning, Lord, I know it happens with me, and I say, good morning, Lord, the Lord responds back, I got you today. And I know I'm not the only one in this house this morning that God lets you know, I got you. He's in control of everything, every breath we take. Every move we make. I know one of those songs said, he'll be watching you, I'll be watching you. Every breath I take, every move. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Some of y'all remember that. But God knows every step we're taking. Have I got a witness in here? He's in control. He was in control before Janet Jackson told y'all. She was in control. These verses also demonstrate the power and the authority of our Lord. Notice what Jesus says in verse 3 if you haven't closed your Bible. He says, see, and this is King James, say ye that the Lord hath need of him. Notice Jesus calls himself Lord. This is a statement of his authority and of his power in this situation. You see, the Lord has power over everything. Not just this situation, but he's got power over your situation. Do you believe that today? Jesus was well known in these villages. He had, after all, just raised Lazarus from the dead. He was a local celebrity. When the owners heard that it was the Lord Jesus who wanted the colt, they immediately set him free. Y'all can have him. If the Lord said it, then hey, here you go. And you know, I think we ought to live like that. Whatever the Lord says, we ought to just say, hey, okay. There's no reason trying to buck God. Why would anybody want to buck God? I mean, he's the one that causes us to inhale and exhale. Haven't got a witness in here. He's the one that causes us to move and have our being. Why would you not do what the Lord says do? Listen, watch this. There's another thing. He says, the Lord had need of him. This is an amazing statement, because when did God, Willie, need? When did God ever need anything? I mean, that one just blew me away in my studying and preparation for this. When did God ever need anything? But that was the paradox of the Lord's life on earth. He was rich, but he became poor. He created every drop of water. But on Calvary, he cried out, I thirst. He created every rock, but he had to borrow a tomb in which to be buried in. He used the clouds as chariots, yet he had to borrow a donkey to ride into Jerusalem. This is the paradox of his life. He was rich, yet he made himself poor so that those who believe, help me, Holy Ghost, might have and enjoy the riches that he has. He owns a cattle on a thousand hills. And if God owns a cattle on a thousand hills, why would I ever be hungry? Now, I want to say a little quick word about the donkey. Give me a couple of minutes and I'll get out of your way. The donkey had to be redeemed. According to Exodus 13:13, and then even in chapter 34 and verse 20. The donkey was alive and useful to the Lord because it had been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Now, that's the only reason you and I have any usefulness to the Lord today. Because of the redeeming power of the blood of Jesus. Have I got to witness it here? This donkey had to be redeemed, and then this donkey had to be released. I'm just giving you a little donkeyology right here. You've heard of soteriology and pneumatology. You've heard of all of the ologies. Let me give you a little donkeyology. He had to be released. It was bound and had to be set free. Anybody in here remember when you were bound? By the power of sin? Don't play with me in here. Anybody remember when you were bound in sin? I don't know what your sin was, but you were bound, and then he released. Before we can be any use to God, we have to be released from the chains of our sins. Must be broken. There's power in the name of Jesus. Did you hear what I said? There's power. I know Tasha Cobbs told y'all that there's power in the name of Jesus to break every chain. But there's power in the name of Jesus. And the power to save is in the blood. What can wash? Weigh my sins. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. All precious is that flow. It makes me whiter than snow. No other fountain I know, nothing but the blood of Jesus. It was the blood, y'all, that made the difference at Calvary. Somebody should have shouted right there. Not only did the donkey have to be redeemed and released, but he had to be ruled. Someone had to take charge over the donkey. Verse 2 tells us the donkey had never been broken, had never been ridden. You trail riders know what I'm talking about, or people from the, I know all y'all wasn't born in Houston. And if you were, you, some of y'all was born when it was the country. This donkey had never been broken. Yet it submitted itself to the authority of Jesus Christ. It submitted itself to the lordship of Jesus. When Jesus got on the horse, the donkey just sat there and rode on. And that's what God expects from us. A surrendered life. All to Jesus. I surrender. All to Him I freely give. I'm just about out of here. The Lord could save sinners and accomplish His work on earth just fine without us if He chooses to. God didn't need us. Have I got a witness in here? To be the change agents in society. He could have used us. Could have used anybody. Yet He chose to use frail human instruments for His glory. But you got to be redeemed. You got to be released. And you got to be ruled by Him so He can use me. Used to hear my daddy sing, "Use me, Lord, in thy service. Draw me nearer every day. If I falter while I'm trying, don't be angry. Just let me stand. I'm willing to run all the way." Verse 6, notice the phrase, "And straightway He will send him hither." This means the Lord will send the donkey right back as soon as He's finished with it. He's not going to put it over in the garage somewhere and forget about it when He gets through. He's going to send it back to the owner. You ever had people to borrow something from you? And they keep it so long that they think it's theirs. They forgot that it was yours. But Jesus sent it back. Have I got a witness in here? But when it came home, this little donkey was ready to be used. This little donkey was ready for a saddle when it got back. He takes what we give Him. When He gives it back, it's far better than it was when He gave it to him. Give Him an Abraham, a lost pagan. He'll give you back an Abraham, a mighty man of faith. Give Him your broken, sin-scarred life, and He'll give you back a new start, a new life, and a new home. I know you like the one in Pearland. I know you like the one in Missouri City, Sugar Land. But this new home, whoo! I really can't wait to get to that new home. Have I got a witness in here? As I mentioned earlier, Jesus is fulfilling the ancient prophecy of Zechariah 9:9. part of that prophecy says that the Messiah will be lowly. That is what we see here. An humble man on a lowly beast. And the people are laying palm trees, branches in the pathway, and are waving palm branches as their king makes his entrance into the city. They are praising his name. I'm not ready for that one. I know y'all trying to push me, but I'm almost there. Watch this. Watch this. They are crying out, Hosanna! Yeah. Hosanna! Yeah. One group would cry, Hosanna, and another group would cry, Hosanna. Yeah. Let me just say that as long as the Lord saves sinners and leaves his saints on earth, he will always have someone to praise his name. Jesus said in Luke, if these should hold their peace, the very rocks would cry out. And the rock. I feel like an old Baptist preacher right now. But I don't want no rocks crying out for me. Jesus went through this procession to fulfill the word of God. But he had another purpose in what he was doing. In fact, he had a double purpose. He examined the town. Mark doesn't really mention it, but Luke does. In chapter 19, as Jesus neared the city, heavenly Holy Ghost, he saw Jerusalem. And he saw their future. He knew that within 40 years, the Romans would besiege the town. He knew that over 30,000 Jews would be crucified by legions marching toward the city. He knew that the Roman general Titus would see piles of dead bodies lying outside the walls of Jerusalem. That he would lift his hands toward heaven to call on God as a witness. It was, if you want to just push me, just put me in E-flat. And I'm a, if that's what you're trying to get me to do, just put me in E-flat and I'll do it. He knew that all these things and more, and Jesus wept. The people are shouting. The people are dancing. The people are singing. They are praising God. And the Lord Jesus, they are excited. They are vocal in their excitement. Not only did he come to examine the town, but he came to examine the temple. The last thing that Jesus did on that day was to visit the temple. He took the time to look at all things. He saw the beauty of the building. He saw the gold and the silver and all the trappings of religion. Can I get a witness? He saw the priests carrying out their rituals. He saw the people bringing their sacrifices to the priest. He saw it all, my brothers and sisters. But one thing you'll notice, they didn't see him. They saw him in the physical, but they didn't see him in the spiritual. I feel pretty good. I'm an old preacher. They saw him
in the physical, but they didn't see him in the spiritual. Have I got a witness? The king entered the temple and they knew nothing of it. The Lord of glory was in his house and they were ignorant of his very presence. I ask myself, Brother Ford, what does Jesus see when he comes to church in America today? What does Jesus see? Does he see people who look like him? Does he see people just going through the motions? Or does he see people who don't mind lifting up their hands and telling the Lord, thank you? I'm glad today that if Jesus came in this morning, that he see me giving him praise. Let the church shout Hosanna. Have I got a witness in him? Because the king has come. And if you know that the king has come, you ought to high five somebody and tell them, I'm glad that he received me. That's what happens when the king comes. He receives those who will come in faith. He restores those who will come home. He refreshes those who are weary. He is here to reward those who are faithful. The question is, do you know him? Have you been redeemed? Have you been restored? Have you been released? Have you been ruled? Say yes, and I'm out of here. Good evening, children. May the Lord bless you real good. I'm glad that I serve the King of Kings. He walks with me and he talks with me and he tells me that I am his own. Say yes. God bless you today. Y'all push me out there. I didn't mean to do that one. Behold, thy king cometh unto thee. I want to sing, Jeffrey, if you don't mind. I want to sing a little song. Put me an E flat. Tis so sweet, the door is open. If you're here today, you can come just as you are to trust in Jesus, just to take him. Why don't you take him this morning? And his word, and just to rest upon his promise. Just to know that saith the Lord. I'm so glad I've learned to trust him. Precious Jesus, he's my Savior. My Savior and Lord, and I know, woo, that he is with me, will be with me till Jesus, Jesus. Anybody know him this morning? Don't sit there and act like you don't know him. How I trust you. Come on, come on, just let it go this morning. How I proved you. Oh, and oh, Jesus. You know, it's something about his name. When I hear it, it make my flesh crawl, make the hair stand up on my head, because I saved me from the pit of hell. Precious, oh, precious Jesus, and oh, for grace. Come on, Lee, let me hear you. Oh, for grace. Oh, for grace to trust you more. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust you. How I proved you. Over, 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 over and again. Jesus, Jesus. Can I say it like I do when I'm in my car? Precious, precious Jesus, and oh, for grace, hallelujah, oh, for grace. I don't know about y'all this morning, but I need a little more grace. I need a little more grace. I need trust you more. Jesus, 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 how I trust you, how I prove you, all in all. Jesus, I used to go hit this note, Darryl, but I can't hear it. I'm going to try it anyway. Now I'm going to lead out with an all precious. Oh, precious Jesus. Oh, oh, grace. Ooh. Oh, for grace. Yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, for grace. To trust you more. Come on and bless the Lord in his house. Now may the grace of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ, bless you, be with you, and keep you as you go this week. The peace of God be with you as you go. God bless you. We'll see you Wednesday night. Oh, for grace. I need a little more grace. I need a little more grace. I need a little more.
You are dismissed. You are dismissed.